word to describe that show, what word would you use?
Great.
Great. I think it's great.
Wonderful. Exciting. Oh. Fantastic. Fun show.
Wow. Okay. That's plenty. Dave, what word would you use? Do you want to add one? Okay. All right. Well, why don't we bring out our first guest, because it is going to be all these things, great and wonderful.
And more.
And more. Okay. Let's please welcome our first guest. Her picture has been downloaded over 2 million times, and you'll know her from all her work with the World Wrestling Federation. Please welcome Sunny. Welcome to the program.
Only on command. How are you?
There we go. Oh, boy. Okay.
I have a little gift for you to start out the show. Your own Sunny t-shirt.
Wow. I'll wear that with pride, Sunny.
I hope so.
What does that mean, get pumped?
Anything you want it to mean, baby.
Okay. This is your thing.
Oh, he's my baby.
Okay, and what's his name?
Baby.
Oh, baby.
I just told you that.
It works out fine.
Where he only bites on command, so you're okay unless you aggravate me a little bit, then I'm like,
right.
Otherwise, he's a pretty cat.
What does baby eat?
He eats 3 mice every 3 weeks live.
Wow.
You have to drizzle him with some vitamins, drop him in, and faster than you can even imagine.
Okay, so he's all pretty well fed now, so he's...
Actually, 2 weeks ago, so he's doing pretty good.
Okay, great.
You want to hold him?
No, that's okay. Sunny. You can hang on to him.
Okay, he'll just hang here all day.
Okay, wow, just like a bracelet.
Just like that.
Can we get along well with 2 of them?
Oh, yeah, he's my guy.
There we go.
Along with my others.
Okay, now I mentioned that you are that your photo is very is downloaded quite a few times, and now this is a very patriotic.
Very patriotic, absolutely, red, white, and blue.
I bet there are fireworks going off all over the country right now. Isn't that nice? Okay, and now this.
That is one of the more popular downloads that have ever been on the internet. I don't know why. I don't know if it's food. I don't know if it's post or what, but guys love that one.
That's the one.
So
huh?
That's one of the one that's the most downloaded. Yeah.
I don't know if David can see that from over there. David, you want to take a look at that?
David.
Okay. All right. Maybe we'll film that a little bit later. Okay.
Weird.
Okay. Now, I also know that you're quite a big fan of Kiss, the musical group.
Yes, I am.
And and you actually do a little tribute to Kiss.
Well, yeah. When we're at home, we have nothing to do. I saw 4 Kiss concerts in last year when they were on tour.
Right.
Absolutely amazing. Haven't had enough. But I've mastered the Gene Simmons face.
You can think, and you'll share that with us.
You want to see it? Yeah.
That'd be great.
Okay. Let's see it.
Yeah.
Ready? Oh, that's great.
Oh, now, I hope you can stay with us, Sunny.
Absolutely.
And baby can stay with us, too.
If you don't mind.
That's fine by me.
I don't think he's really going anywhere right now, so even if you want him out, he's pretty much... Hanging in there.
Okay, hanging in. All right. Well, let's, without further ado, bring out our next guest so we can all be together. Please welcome Mr. Scott Baker.
Working in a freak show on Coney Island, I learned a lot about our environment. You'd be surprised what washes up on the seashore, like this, for instance. That's right. Coney Island whitefish. A snapper. They're so versatile, too. Now, I know if you're anything like me, you're thinking of one thing and one thing only right now, and that, of course, is Shakespeare. What a piece of work is man. How noble in reason, how infinite in faculty, in form and movement, how express and admirable. In action, how like an angel. In apprehension, how like a god. Beauty of the world, the paragon of animals. What a piece of work is man!
Wow.
What a piece of work!
Exactly.
He likes you.
Yeah.
There we go.
He doesn't like you.
Oh, well, one snake deserves another. I don't know.
Okay. Have you ever tried that, Chris, honey? That's
No. I don't think I will.
Okay.
But he does it so wonderfully, I'll leave it all to him.
No, there thank you, Sonny. Thank you.
All right, well, please stay with us, Mr. Baker and Sonny. We have lots more ahead. Melissa, maybe you can tell us what's ahead.
Sure. We have a mom who's going to use her daughter as a shopping cart, and also a new invention that's going to keep your doggy from wetting himself. So don't go away.
Hey, well, you can't do that.
Why not?
I don't know, because it's wrong.
I always give. Now I'm taking. It's like, give a penny, take a penny.
I would feel streetwise.
Yeah, it seems kind of low.
Your it don't mind, do you, Ed? See, Iz is cool with it.
That's very convincing. Yeah, not everyone's Howard.
Just give me the dollar. I'll give him back a quarter. We'll call it easy.
He's trying to be nice, Howard. Nice.
What's the problem?
You have no shame.
Austin Stories. Every week, a different story. Premieres next Wednesday, 10:30 at the 10 spot.
Oddbill on MTV is yours thanks to Reebok, helping athletes perform at the top of their game.
My name is Kimberly Castellano. I'm 14 and I play football.
We're at the Reebok Cup.
Oh, we're watching it, we're thinking about it,
dreaming about it.
The tension can get pretty wild, especially the championship game.
You either like play tough or else you're gonna be like on the ground.
Being together is like the best part of like.
I hope to make the national team when I'm older, but it's gonna be a lot of work.
And every time I have to do it, he's gonna give it all my heart.
Come on!
To save the world. If he succeeds, you survive. If he fails, you can always hit the reset button. Final Fantasy VII, only on PlayStation.
And marketing wants you guys to hold the kudos bars closer to the camera. Next, the correct way to say kudos is dipped in chocolate is to say it's in rose. And could you start saying that those oats and grains really pack a punch? And lastly,
Wes Craven presents. He will tempt you with your every desire and will turn your wildest dreams into your worst nightmare.
People on the show look like my dad when I make really dorky-looking faces. I got horrible sense of timing from my mother. I got scrawny chicken legs from my dad and a nice big nose. I learned how to tell a white lie trying to outsmart my mother. When comes in.
Out the door, honey.
What?
The door could be closed this way.
Yeah, what a door.
I know, right? I mean, get a clue.
Oh, boy.
to on my own. I was dragged along to when I was like 12. And that was the first time that I wanted to go out and buy a leather jacket and, you know, join a gang.
When I was little, it was all Kiss. It really thought I could want to be a Guitar Hero. And so somewhere between Kiss and Waylon Jennings, I arrived here. Nowadays, it's a lot of these guys that are kind of making an interesting racket on the old six string. Fans like Spiritualized or the Flaming Lips or the Jesus Lizard.
I always go back to London Calling, no matter what year it is. The classic London Calling, I think it's a record that just about anybody should own.
Okay, welcome back to the program. Wow, what a show today. Sunny, everything going okay?
Oh, everything's wonderful.
Baby seems to be getting along.
Oh, he loves it here.
It's fine? Okay.
I think it's the perfect, you know, area for him.
Great.
He's very comfortable.
Okay, and Mr. Baker, you're comfortable?
I'm having the time of my life.
Good, okay. Melissa, everything?
Great time, thanks.
All right, well, without further ado, let's bring out our next guest. Please welcome Ms. Sheila and Ms. Lindsay Hellman. And you are?
Mm-hmm.
Lindsay. Okay. And you are Sheila. Okay. Now, you're actually mom and daughter,
yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And now, what are you going to share with us today?
We're going to demonstrate a human supermarket basket.
Oh. Okay. Well, that sounds great. Please go to it.
Hi. My name is Sheila. And I'm blessed and chosen among women. For the day that God blessed me with my daughter, Lindsay, I could throw away these ugly plastic and metal shopping carts. All I need to do is when I go to the supermarket is ask Lindsay, my daughter, to go along with me, and I don't have to worry about carrying this ugly basket. I simply take Lindsay, she does her thing, I put my groceries in my human basket, and voila. We're free to move on and shop in the supermarket. That I had to find a new thing in life because she got a little bit bigger, so I had to go into bodybuilding, and that became my new hobby. Now, when we go home, Lindsay also does something she can double as my human lawn ornament, so when company comes over, my yard looks great. And we never have a dull moment or a rainy Saturday night in the Hellman household. We just have Lindsay to do her new thing to entertain us all. We're never bored.
Are you afraid
of snakes?
Sure. There we go. Jill, you're not afraid of snakes, are you?
I guess not. Not anymore.
Okay, there we go. Perfect.
Oh, great.
Now, Jill, I know you're kind of a hip mom. You like to play roller hockey with the kids.
Yes,
is that right?
Do.
Wow. Is she pretty tough, your mom, when she's playing?
Sometimes.
You ever check anyone?
Yes, we do.
It's pretty rough. Okay. All right. Well, stick with us. Lots more coming. Please welcome Mr. Mike Amato. How do you do, Mr. Amato?
Very good, Frank. Thank you.
Welcome to the program.
Glad to be here.
All right. Now, you, professionally, you are a truant officer.
Attendant right? Teacher, they call us now, yes.
Okay. And now, is that a tough job?
Well, we visit many homes when children aren't in school, and we try to get them back in school.
So if a kid's playing hooky, you go and you find them. And
we round them up and we bring them back.
Bring them back in. Okay. Now, but in addition to that, you are also an inventor.
Yes.
And what is it that you've invented?
Well, we have a doggy umbrella.
A doggy umbrella?
Yes.
Okay, and this is the doggy umbrella here.
Part of it, yes. Yes. Have you ever tried to hold an umbrella both over a dog and yourself in the rain?
Yes. Oh, I have.
Very difficult thing to do, isn't it?
Yeah,
right.
Well,
so,
wouldn't it be nice if the dog held his own umbrella, so to speak?
Oh, so the dog could hold his own umbrella and the person would hold their own umbrella?
Yes.
Okay, but how, now a dog, not with his paw.
No, we have, we can demonstrate it for you.
Okay, and I know you did bring some people with you today.
Yes.
You brought some volunteers. Please welcome Dana and Ralph Feldman. Okay, you're Dana.
Yes.
Okay, and welcome, Mr. Mm-hmm. Feldman.
I have to keep baby away from him. He might think it's feeding time.
Oh, boy. Okay. And this is Ralph.
Ralph, I'm already.
Okay. And now, so maybe you can show us how this works with
okay.
Ralph.
Okay. The beauty of the doggy umbrella is that it mounts to a conventional harness and collar.
Okay.
It just snaps on with Velcro.
Okay.
And
okay. This might be good in the sun, too. It's sort of a parasol.
Yes, keeps them protected from the sun and also from the rain.
Okay. There you go, Ralph.
It just snaps on very easily.
Okay.
And the dog won't even know he's wearing it, except for the fact that it remains dry. The dog holds his own umbrella.
Wow.
All right. Maybe Ms. Feldman, you can walk Ralph around a little bit so we can see how this works in action here. There we go.
He's adorable.
That's pretty good. Now, Melissa, you have some water, right, so we can demonstrate how this actually works.
I'll demonstrate.
Okay.
Oh, the poor thing.
Oh, no.
Okay. Oh,
just a few drops. Now, this is water repellent, right, Mr. Romano?
Certainly.
Okay. All right. Have a seat and join us here. I'll tell you, he ran a little bit and got a little spooked by it, but it did keep him dry, right?
Yeah, certainly.
Right. Okay. Now, when did you first come up with this invention?
Actually, about 2 years ago.
2 years ago.
Somebody made a suggestion to me. I wish somebody would invent a dog umbrella.
Right.
And so I took the idea and I worked with it.
Now, I know the date August 20 is very significant, right? And why is that?
Well, that's not only my birthday, it's also the date of my wedding.
Right.
And also the date that our first patent was issued on the doggy umbrella.
Wow.
Same date.
Special day, August 20. Okay. Well, please stay with us. We have lots more coming up. We're going to have streams of bubbles, smoke-filled bubbles, and huge handmade bubbles, plus the music of Smash Mouth. So don't go away.
What's going to be remembered this era is going to be, I predict, man working with machine. A very happy marriage. And I think we're coming into a time where we're going to relish the idea of dance. And sometimes the intention of music isn't to make people dance, but I think it's very popular right now to try to entice people into dancing, and I think it's so healthy.
Advil and MTV is yours thanks to Reebok, helping athletes perform at the top of their game.
My name is Kimberly Castiano. I'm 14 and I play forward.
We're at the Reebok Cup.
Oh, we're watching it. We're thinking about it.
Dreaming about it.
The tension can get pretty loud, especially the championship game.
You're going to, like, play tough or else you're going to be, like, on the ground.
Being together is, like, the best part of, like...
I hope to make the national team when I'm older, but it's going to be a lot of work.
And I always try my hardest to do it. I'm going to give it all my heart.
Come on!
Snowpox 2-1.
Then a storm comes up. And I'm the one who's got to get us out of this. And I remember who gave me courage. This is for them. For my mom and dad, who never missed a game. And for Bill Sergeant McCardle, who showed me what it takes to be a leader. And for myself, who became one.
And marketing wants you guys to hold the kudos bars closer to the camera. Next, the correct way to say kudos is dipped in chocolate is to say it's in rose. And could you start saying that those oats and grains really pack a punch? And lastly...
Bull had a commercial contest for students.
I would do something with the cap.
That's a winner.
You won't admit you love me, and so am I ever. No, you always tell me.
Oliver Stone.
back.
Yeah, that makes you all hot and sweaty.
Murder.
Kill him.
Betrayal.
You guys didn't take the money and dump me.
And everything else that makes life worth living.
You think bad, then bad's what you get.
Sean Penn, Jennifer Lopez, and Nick Nolte. U-Turn.
Is everybody in this town on drugs?
Rated R. Opens everywhere October 3rd.
Hungry? Then bite the Burt. Only Burt gum crystallizes these flavors into a delicious taste at last. Chew after chew after chew. Burt makes you hungry for gum.
I was born in America. I live in Richmond, so I have a London accent. My mum, I get my quiet side from my dad. Get a lot of sense of humour and stuff like that. A really stupid humour. He's taught me a lot about music. We both have a real musical gene together, you know. We're both heavily into that.
The label that created a scene with Ultimate Dance Party 1997 wants you to check out the coolest new party album of the year. Harris's Ultimate New Wave Party features 18 of the biggest chart-topping hits of the new wave era. These are the classic new wave hits that shaped a decade. Ultimate New Wave Party is available now through this outstanding CD offer. Cassette $12.98, CD $17.98. The Romantics, Berlin, The Cars, Flock of Seagulls, Modern English. The list of classic number one new wave hits goes on and on. Make no mistake about it. This is the ultimate new wave album of all time. Order it now and rock the night away.
Technology. That four-syllable word that's making things possible that we never dreamed of before. Faster, cheaper, but not always better. Better comes from those who study at the Art Institute, where creativity, technology, and technique are merged with master instruction to prepare tomorrow's visionary.
You can be one of them by calling the Art Institute International, 1-800-776-6570. That's 1-800-776-6570.
Even more amazing. Please welcome Mr. Tom Brezzadola.
Thank you.
It's my own recipe for it, and it helps to keep those bubbles really big, but it's a real clean act, real clean act.
It's clean, that's true. Yeah. Now, you've been doing this for years, right?
Yeah, I started when I was about 12 years old. I had to figure out I can do all these neat different things with the bubbles.
And now you're the bubble master.
Yes.
All right,
yes.
Okay. Well, now please stay with us, everybody, because I know everyone's going to love this band that's coming out. They're going to be doing their song, Walking on the Sun, from the album Push You Mang. Please welcome from San Jose, California, Smash Mouth.
With a tear because her bed and I have been remote. The bond is broke, just so close, I've been so kissed on the coast. I'll be so weird, 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 I'll be so